Again, I am repeating the question. The question is, these two equations are given. First, we have to check whether these are consistent or inconsistent. Here in this case, both constant are on the right side. तो आप इसको right side से भी कर सकते हो. दोनों एक side पे, अगर एक right side पे होता, दूसरा left side पे होता, तब हम उसको एक side पे करते, like left hand side. अगर ऐसे भी कर दोगे, even then it is right. और if you write x plus y minus y equal to 0, 2x plus 2y minus 10 equal to 0, तब भी वो सही है. Clear करन? Now we have to find the ratio a1 over a2 which is 1 over 2, b1 over b2 which is 1 over 2, c1 over c2 which is 1 over 2. All three ratios are equal. It means equations are consistent. Equations are consistent. If they are consistent, then we have to find the solution graphically. Graphically solution find out करने के लिए, first of all, we find minimum three solutions in each case. दोनों equation same है तो दोनों के solution same लिख सकते हैं. Then you have to plot the graph. Start writing. X-axis. This is y-axis. Origin. Then take 1, 2. Maximum value of x is 5, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When x is 0, y is y. B point आ जाएगा 0, 5. When x is 5, y is 0, 5, 0. X is 2, y is 3, 2, 3. तो इस तरह आपकी स्ट्रेट लाइन बन जाएगी. स्ट्रेट लाइन, दिस लाइन रिप्रेजेंट द लाइन x प्लस y इज इक्वल टू 5. जब आप सेकेंड लाइन बनाओगे वो भी सेम पॉइंट्स की है, तो इसी सेम सेकेंड लाइन भी सेम बनेगी. 2x प्लस 2y इज इक्वल टू 10. सो इन दिस केस हाउ मेनी सॉल्यूशंस आर पॉसिबल? इनफाइनाइट मेनी सॉल्यूशंस. सो यू विल राइट इनफाइनाइट सॉल्यूशंस आर पॉसिबल. हरी अब ड्रॉ द ग्राफ. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क. क्लियर? फर्स्ट वी री राइट द इक्वेशंस. नाउ कंपेयर द रेशियोज ऑफ a1 ओवर a2 is 1 over 3, b1 over b2, minus 1, coefficient of y is minus 1 over minus 3, which is equal to 1 over 3, then c1 into over c2, this is equal to minus 8 over minus 16, which is equal to 1 over 2. Therefore, a1 over a2 is equal to b1 over b2, but not equal to c1 over C2. So pair of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent in this case? Raise your hand.
Inconsistent.
Inconsistent. Because here first two ratios are equal but not equal to the third one. So inconsistent. Inconsistent. If they are inconsistent, then no solution is possible. So simple, right? Pair of linear equations are inconsistent. Pair of linear equations are inconsistent. Write down. Those who have done, they can start the third part of this question. Any question regarding this part, second part? Okay, no one. So third part is 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. And the second one is 4x minus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0. Already constant terms are on left hand side. So first we compare the ratios a1 over a2. 2 over 4, which is equal to 1 over 2. Then b1 over b2. This is equal to 1 over minus 2, or we can write minus 1 over 2. Then c1 over c2. Here both a1 over a2 is not equal to b1 over b2. Obviously, if the first two equal nahi hai, to wo third ke equal nahi ho sakti. So a1 over a2 is not equal to b1 over b2 is not equal to b1 over b2. Therefore, system of equations or pair of equations are consistent. Therefore, pair of linear equations are consistent. अगर कंसिस्टेंट है तो हम ग्राफिकली इसका सोल्यूशन फाइंड आउट कर सकते हैं. हाउ मेनी सोल्यूशंस आर पॉसिबल इन दिस केस? रेज योर हैंड. हाउ मेनी सोल्यूशंस आर पॉसिबल?
यस,
वन
वन मैम,
वन. बिकॉज अगर ये इक्वल नहीं है, इट मींस ये इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइंस बनेंगी इनके ग्राफ के, एंड इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइन में वन यूनिक सोल्यूशन इज पॉसिबल. सो आर यू ड्रॉ द ग्राफ ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. You have to draw it yourself. First, find the minimum three solutions for both the equations and then draw the graph. Take 2 minutes to draw the graph of this equation. First equation is 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. So we can write y is equal to 6 minus 2x. Find the minimum three solutions. If x is 0, y is 6. If x is 1, y is 4. If x is 2, y is 2. Similarly, for the another equation, I am rewriting the equation. We can take 2 as a common factor. So equation will become 2x minus y minus 2 equal to 0, or you can say y is equal to 2x minus 2. Y to dusri side lege. So y is equal to 2x minus 2. Now again find the minimum 3 solutions in this equation. X and y. If x is 0, y is minus 2. If x is 1, y is 0. If x is 2, y is 2. Now draw the graph. X-axis. Must write the name of the axis, x axis and y axis origin. Maximum value of x is 2, 1, 2, 3, and maximum value of y is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and minus 1, minus 2, minus 1, minus 2. Then x is 0, y is 6. This point must write the coordinates along with the point 0, 6, x is 1, y is 4, 1, 4, x is 2, y is 2, 2, 2. Now draw the line. This line represents equation 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. Now the second line, x is 0, y is minus 2. This point 0, minus 2. Then x is 1, y is 0, x1, y is 0, x is 2, y is 2. So this is your second line. This equation, line of equation of this line is 4x minus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0. Now the both lines intersect at point 2, 2. Therefore, solution of given equations is x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2. So this is the solution. Dono lines just point pe intersect karengi, that is your solution. Clear? Any doubt regarding this question, you can ask. Fourth part is 2x minus 2y minus 2 is equal to 0. 2x minus 2y minus 2 is equal to 0, and other is 4x minus 4y minus 5 is equal to 0. Now first compare the ratios. Constant time terms are already on the left hand side. A bar over A2 is 2
over 4, which is equal to 1 over 2. B1 over B2 is equal to minus 2 over minus 4, which is equal to 1 over 2. C1 over C2 is equal to minus 2 over 5, minus 5, which is equal to 2 over 5. Therefore, A1 over A2 is equal to B1 over B2, but not equal to C1 over C2. Therefore, given pair of equations is inconsistent. If it is inconsistent, then no solution is possible. So write down equations are, or you can write pair of equations are inconsistent.
Clear? Any doubt in any part of this question, you can ask, or we can, or we will start our next question number 5. Do it, hurry up.
Let us start next question, question number 5.
Fifth question is, half the perimeter of rectangular garden whose length is 4 meter more than width. Means two things are there, length and breadth.
Let us suppose that length of rectangular field garden and length of rectangular garden is equal to x, and width of rectangular garden is equal to y. If length and width are x and y, then what is the perimeter? Perimeter is 2 into l plus d. So perimeter is 2x plus y.
Clear? Now they said half the perimeter of rectangular garden.
According to question, half the perimeter,
2x plus y ka jab half karenge,
what do we get? X plus y.
Half the perimeter of a rectangular garden whose length is 4 meter more than its width is 36 meter.
This is equal to 36
meter. Clear? उन्होंने कहा है जो perimeter का जितना half है वो किसके equal है 36 meter. And relation between length and width is 4 meter more than its width.
Length is x is equal to 4 meter more than width.
Length is 4 meter more. More means plus 4 meter more than its width.
So second equation is, this is your first equation. Second is x minus y is equal to 4. This is your second equation.
Clear? Now next is find the dimensions of the garden. There are two methods to find. One is graphically, other is by solving these equations. Clear? अभी हमने equations को solve कैसे करना है वो अभी हम next topic में पढ़ेंगे. So you have to find the solutions graphically. For graphically, first we check whether the system of equations are consistent or inconsistent.
For that, A1 over A2 is 1 over 1, b1 over b2 is equal to 1 over minus 1. Therefore, a1 over a2 is not equal to b1 over b2.
It means linear equations are consistent. If they are consistent, then we can find the solution, and the graph of these two equations will be intersecting lines. So one unique solution is possible. Clear? So first write down this, then write down equations are consistent.
Equations are consistent.
Then draw the graph.
For graph, find the minimum three solutions. For the first equation is this, if x is 36 and 4, take any 4. Three solution, if x is 10, y is 26. If x is 16, y is 20. If x is 20, y is 16. Clear? Similarly, draw for the second equation, minimum three solutions. If y is 4, 26. X is 30. If y is 20, x is 24. If y is 16, x is 20. Draw the graph of these two equations. Draw the graph and check the intersecting points. Graph में आप 10-10 का scale ले सकते हो. Maximum value 26 तक है और you can take the scale of 5. 1-2 मत लेना, graph बहुत बड़ा हो जाएगा. 5 का scale ले लो और इधर 10 का scale. And must write down the scale. Question number 6 is, given the linear equation, one equation is given, 2x plus 3y minus 8 is equal to 0. Write another linear equation in two variables such that the geometrical representation of the pair so formed is intersecting lines. First, हमने लिखना है for equation for intersecting lines. Intersecting lines. And we know that in intersecting lines, A1 over A2 is not equal to B1 over B2. तो हमें equation इस तरह की कोई भी एक equation लिखनी है जिससे ratio of A1, A2, B1, B2 के equal ना हो. You can write any equation. 5x minus 7y minus 10 is equal to 0. A1 over A2 is not equal to B1 over B2. You can write any equation. जरूरी नहीं जो मैंने board पे लिखी है आपने भी वही लिखनी है. You can write any equation such that these two pair of equations represent intersecting lines. Clear? Second one is for parallel lines. For parallel lines, what is the condition for the parallel lines? First two ratios are equal but not equal to the third one. First two are equal. Suppose I am writing 4x plus 6y minus 9 is equal to 0. What I did? Simple, first two को 2 से multiply कर दिया मैंने. आप ना भी करो, multiply same लिख दो. 2x plus 3y सिर्फ constant की value change करो. Even then it is right. ठीक है, मैंने यहाँ पे क्या किया, सिर्फ फर्स्ट टू टर्म्स को 2 से मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया. व्हेन यू टेक द रेशियो 2 ओवर 4, 1/2, 3 ओवर 6, अगेन 1/2, विच इज नॉट इक्वल टू -8 ओवर -9. क्लियर? सो दिस रिप्रेजेंट द पेयर ऑफ पैरेलल लाइंस. थर्ड वन इज फॉर कोइंसिडेंट लाइन. कोइंसिडेंट लाइंस के लिए क्या है? बोथ इक्वेशन शुड बी सेम. यहाँ तो आप सेम यही इक्वेशन लिख दो और यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई दिस इक्वेशन और यू कैन डिवाइड दिस इक्वेशन बाय एनी नंबर. क्लियर? आई एम गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस बाय 3. 3x प्लस 9y माइनस 24 इज इक्वल टू 0. रेशियो सेम आएगी, 3 से मल्टीप्लाई किया तो यहाँ 6 आएगा. 1 over 3 minus 8 over minus 24 is 1 over 3. All three ratios are equal, so this represent the pair of coincident lines. Note down this question. Seventh question will be in your homework and the question is, draw the graphs of the equation. Two equations दी हुई हैं आपको. First of all, you check whether the equations are consistent or inconsistent. जब भी आपको ऐसे graph बनाने को बोला जाए, आपने direct graph नहीं start कर देना. First of all, you have to check whether the equations are consistent or inconsistent. पहले इन दोनों को check करेंगे. Obviously, these two equations are consistent. Determine the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle formed by these two lines and the x-axis. उसके बाद आपको क्या करना है, सपोज कि इसका ग्राफ आपके पास इस तरह का बना. सपोज कि इस तरह का ग्राफ बना. दिस इज द लाइन फॉर द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन, दिस इज द लाइन फॉर द सेकंड इक्वेशन.
then you have to check the vertices of the triangle formed by these lines and the x-axis. अब ट्राइंगल दो बने हुए हैं, one is this, other is this. उन्होंने क्या कहा है, किस ट्राइंगल को आपने शेड करना है, जो x-axis के साथ ट्राइंगल बन रही है. क्लियर, x-axis के साथ ये ट्राइंगल बन रही है, you have to shade it. इस ट्राइंगल को शेड कर दोगे, then write down the vertices of this triangle. Vertices कैसे find out करने हैं, one is this, intersecting point, इसका vertex क्या होगा, second on the points on the x-axis, इनके vertices लिखने हैं. क्लियर, इस टाइप के क्वेश्चंस हमने नाइन्थ क्लास में किए थे, इफ यू रिमेम्बर नाइन्थ में हमने इस टाइप के क्वेश्चंस किए थे. क्लियर, सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज इन योर होमवर्क, क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. नाउ एनी डाउट इन दिस, एनी क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज 3.2, इफ यू डोंट हैव एनी डाउट वी विल प्रोसीड फॉर द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. Write down next is algebraic, give heading, algebraic methods of solving the pair of linear equations. अभी हम क्या कर रहे थे, ज्योमेट्रिकल ग्राफिकल मेथड, ग्राफ से हमने सॉल्यूशंस फाइंड आउट किए. नाउ अलजेब्रिकली हाउ कैन वी फाइंड द सॉल्यूशंस, फर्स्ट इज देयर आर थ्री मेथड्स by which you can solve the equations. First is substitution method. Give heading, substitution method. Now what is this method? Suppose we have an equation x plus y is equal to 3 and the second one is x plus 2y is equal to 4. Suppose these two equations we have. Clear? Now as the name indicates, substitution. Substitution का क्या मतलब है? हमें एक equation में से किसी एक variable की value find out करनी है and we will put that value in the second equation. Suppose this is our first equation, this is the second equation. Let us find the value of any one variable from the first equation. Suppose I am finding y. Y is equal to 3 minus x. Ab second mein se bhi find out kar sakte ho. Clear? From any one equation. First mein se humne y ki value find out ki. Kya aa gaya? Y is equal to 3 minus x. Now substitute this value in second equation. Put y is equal to 3 minus x in equation. सेकेंड इक्वेशन में इसको पुट करेंगे, सेकेंड इक्वेशन में पुट करके हमारे पास क्या आएगा, x as it is plus 2, y, y की वैल्यू कितनी है, 3 minus x is equal to 4. Clear? So x is x plus, ब्रैकेट से मल्टीप्लाई हो जाएगा, 6 minus 2x is equal to 4. ये कितना आएगा, minus x, minus 2x is minus x. कांस्टेंट शिफ्ट हो जाएगा, 4 माइनस 6, सो माइनस एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस 2, सो एक्स इज इक्वल टू 2, एक्स की वैल्यू आ गई 2, इस एक्स की वैल्यू को हम यहाँ पुट करके वाई की वैल्यू फाइंड आउट कर सकते हैं, देयरफॉर वाई इज इक्वल टू 3 माइनस 2 इक्वल टू 1, सो वैल्यू ऑफ वाई इज इक्वल टू 1, दिस इज कॉल्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड. What is substitution method? We find the value of one variable from any one equation, either one, second, first equation or second equation, then put that value in another equation. Note down this example.